Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty speaking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a metallic feather. We're going to use some gel polish and we're also going to use some gold leaf. Now, our fabulous model today, Kate, said, oh, it's like a feather, like from a chick, because it's Easter. Or a feather when you find a white feather, because we got all spiritual then, which went a bit crazy. The conversation did. No ghosts. There's no ghosts in here today, is there? We haven't found no white feathers, but we are going to use the gold leaf to create this feather as well as gel polish. Now, when you get the gold leaf, it's in a little pack like this, and there it is. It's very, very beautiful. But also very delicate, so you've got to be really careful with it. So what I'm going to do first of all is put on my background colour, which is, so the colour is a nice lavender colour, which is 968. It may have a name, but we don't know what it is. So it's a nice spring colour. You can see how pigmented this is. This design will only work if your gel polish is really pigmented. Tap that end, pop it into the lamp. What I'm going to do is break off some pieces, so they're a lot smaller. So you can see that this sheet will last a long, long time. So I'm going to use that piece first. Now this gel polish has a very slight sticky layer, so it'll stick to it very, very easily. And you're just going to, with a clean finger, flatten that out. Then I want some of it. Thinner than that. Yep. It is fiddly. So as I put each one down, I am thinking about the feather and where I want everything to be. I'm planning it out in my head. So because that's a little one, I'm going to put that right at the end. So that's perfect size for that. Right, what you're going to do now is you're going to take something that is pointy. So you can use a cuticle pusher. So I'll show you what I mean. So you could use the cuticle knife on the end of your cuticle pusher. You could even use, on the end of your pinching tool, you have a little cuticle knife. So anything that's sort of pointy. And what you're going to do is you're going to drag in little lines to create that feather look. So you're sort of breaking it open. Don't worry about it being perfect, because we're going to get to that point. So that's all you need to do for now. Pop that away because it's so fragile. I don't want it to blow everywhere, because even your breath makes it float. And dragon breath will make it disintegrate. So you're going to take your colour now, pop some on the backing paper of a sculpting form. It's a good way to utilise this, because else it would just go in the bin. So save it.
Yeah, somebody said that the other day. They were like, I can't believe you're just wasting forms.
Yeah, I get that. But I have loads because I sculpt lots of nails. So I just have reams of it left. Mm. So I'm using it instead of putting it in the bin. So now you're going to take your colour. And you're going to go around the edge. Don't worry about going too neat. This will just start to neaten it up. The thing with the foil is you can't like sit and cut it out to the shape you want because it's so fragile. I'm going to roughly go around the edge, and what it'll do is it'll slightly neaten it up a little bit. And once you've gone around the edge, we're going to fill the nail. And you want to do it really thin, so drag your brush like this so you're dragging off any excess. You can get really close and tight to the cuticle this way as well. And like I say, you need a gel polish that is really pigmented to do this. I'm going to cure that in the lamp. Now the next step is to seal this in. So what we're going to do is top coat it with the Urban Graffiti top coat. This has no tacky layer, so you don't need to wipe off any residue or anything. You just go in the lamp, cure it, and it's all sealed in. Pop that in the lamp for me. Then we're going to use some snow white gel polish. And this is what's really going to make this design come to life. I'm going to take a detailing brush. I'm going to go down the centre. Really fine. Just flash cure that for me. So this is your tricky part. You're going to go round the outside to edge the feather. And bring in some lines so you can see how that's edging it and making it more defined. This is what really makes it pop. So keep everything nice and thin. You can always add more, but you can't take it off. once you're happy with one side, you're going to cure that, and then you can work on the other side without thinking you're going to knock it. So pop me that on. So because I've flash cured this side, if my finger touches it, it doesn't matter. What you can do is some random little tiny lines to add to the effect. It'll make it look like a little bit more hairy or feathery. Right, pop me that on the lamp. Right, what I'm going to do now is seal all this in. And the reason that I did the top coat before is because I wanted everything to be sealed. I wanted to work on top of a shiny surface while I was doing the white. It makes it crisper. I didn't want to work on top of that sticky layer that the gel polish colour has. But now this is just going to seal everything in. We're going to cure that, and then we're going to add a little bit of bling. I'm going to add some bling using a little bit of acrylic to adhere it on. You don't need to use acrylic. You can use mega gloss, but this stone's quite big. So I do prefer to use acrylic on big stones. Let that acrylic dry and then get your brush on glue and just add a little bit of that around the edge. It'll seal everything in. It'll also take the shine off the acrylic as well. Gonna finish with some cuticle oil. There you are, guys, that's how to create a foil feathered look. It's quite simple. You just need a bit of gel polish and a bit of foil. And obviously a little bit of bling, because you've got to bling it up, haven't you? Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and also subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye. What my kids do in the morning, and try to give them a kissy like that. Mum, no, no, the breath, Mum, no. Oh. So nice, aren't they? So nice to me.